Hi, everyone. I'm Christina Spicer with Circa. Former First Lady Barbara Bush has passed away at 92 years old. And here with me to talk about her legacy is Andrew Oak, the First Lady's man. Thank you so much for joining me.
It's nice to be here, even on what is typically a sad occasion, but one that I think we should remember Barbara Bush as she lived her life.
Okay.
Happy, positive, smiling, moving forward. So, you know, at 92 years old, being married for 73 years, we should all be so lucky and to leave a legacy that is unprecedented by other human beings and certainly other first ladies, one of our most productive and prolific post-White House first ladies. I think it's just to memorialize and celebrate her legacy is just a wonderful opportunity.
Definitely. And at 92 years old, it definitely seems like she lived a great life.
Very full.
Yeah. I would imagine because you have, you know, researched so much about the first ladies that you've grown close with their stories. How did the news first affect you?
But that's an excellent point, is that closeness. You know, when you go to every library, home, church, birthplace, and look through personal letters and items, you can't feel, I couldn't help feel, a closeness to this woman and these women. I think my initial surprise was just that she was ailing. I mean, beyond the fact that it's a 92-year-old woman, we see her most recently in the public as that strong symbol, that matriarch of the Bush dynasty, pushing her husband in a wheelchair from the landing pads of his birthday parachute jumps, the coin toss at the Super Bowl. She is the greater woman behind this great man, literally and physically. So the fact that she was ailing and not too many people knew it is not a surprise because she's such a strong woman. And I was a little bit sad because, you know, she does do so much and did do so much right up to her final days with her philanthropic endeavors and the good work that she did. But this is a legacy and a platform that she has put in place that will outlast all of us, her lasting efforts.
Definitely. And that's amazing that she was so strong for her family and then also so strong for the country. What would you say was her greatest impact on the country?
I think in the public eye, her greatest impact is her literacy campaign. You know, teaching people to read and write and be productive and be part of society and something that she was so passionate. And that's a billion with a B dollar philanthropy. They raised 50 some million dollars a year in that in the post White House years with bookmobile events and reading events at the library and College Station. She's one of our first ladies with the most libraries, medical facilities, memorials named after her, and that's something that people don't know a too terrible amount about her work in Maine at the Barbara Bush Memorial Hospital in Portland. The work that she did with terminally ill children, children that are recovering from procedures and things, again, is unprecedented. The work that she did up there up until very recently.
That's amazing. That seems she really like was involved and had a passion for the people of our country, which I think is amazing.
She's a genuine woman. One thing that I've been telling so many people and have long before today is that the people that I know that worked in the White House and continue to work in the White House, Secret Service agents, stewards, butlers, people that aren't associated with an administration, that is a career for them. They've been in the White House working for multiple administrations and multiple first ladies. Time and time again, they say they were sorriest to see Barbara Bush move out. This is a woman that even the people that saw what could be considered the behind the scenes, the unfavorable aspects of someone's life, when you follow them around 24/7 and you're their security detail or you're helping them organize parties and events, you could see a less attractive side of someone.
Yeah.
But no one has a bad thing to say about Barbara
that's
Bush.
So good.
If you can do that in life, that's an achievement. If you can do that in politics, it's unprecedented.
Yeah.
There's no other first lady that can say there's no one that has anything bad to say about her. It's truly remarkable.
Right, and the fact that they wanted her to stay, like, that really says
yes. Politics aside, they just wanted her to, she remembered people's names, people's children's names, people's pets' names, knew when someone was ailing at home, and knew when to give a little care package for no other reason than just to wish someone well. She walked the walk, she talked the talk, she was a genuine human being, and everyone around her knew it.
Definitely. I know when we first spoke, we talked about, you know, the role of a first lady.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel that Barbara Bush really upheld the role of First Lady.
She did. You know, her daughter-in-law, okay, Laura Bush, brings up a very good point when she said, the role of the First Lady is for each individual First Lady to make their own. There's no, as we've talked about, there's no description. There's no pay. They're not elected. Anyone can make it their own. And Barbara Bush did it in such a quiet, effective way where she wasn't a spotlight First Lady. She wasn't a, hey, look at me, which is fine. We need those First Ladies. We want them in our pop culture. We want to emulate their style, their hairstyles, their hemlines, and everything else. But then Barbara Bush was this eternal grandmother, eternal mother to so many people, so many walks of life, so many demographics, and she did it with such quiet effectiveness that looking back on her life, it's almost as though she lived to be twice as old, you know, 184, is that you just can't imagine packing this much good work into your life and this much public service for the majority of her adult life. But also consider this, Barbara Bush stressed at every corner, every turn, to spend more time with your family, with your loved ones. And she did this. She led by example there too. She had scrapbooks from when she and George H.W. Bush started dating in the 40s, documenting their entire lives of this most successful family dynasty, political dynasty in American history.
What would you say is your favorite thing that you learned about Barbara Bush when you went on your journey?
One of the favorite things I saw that I physically held was one of her scrapbooks from one of her she said that her favorite time when she was in China. The Bushes were over there, just H.W. and Barbara were over there without children. Their children had grown enough or were in school or in their late teens, early 20s that they could take care of themselves. There was no embassy. There was no staff. The Bushes were just sent there to establish diplomatic relations. They were basically tourists, but representing America. And they were bicycling through Beijing and on the Great Wall and going to luncheons and having tea parties. And that was another great thing about Barbara Bush. When she entertained, everyone was welcome. She's from an almost forgotten era of bipartisan politics where they truly meant it and they didn't care what party that you were in. They knew that there was compromise and work to be done together for the betterment of the American people and the world. And again, Mrs. Bush, as always, led by example.
That's great. Is there anything that you would say was any stories that people might not know, you know? Whether they're unusual or just interesting.
Sure. We see the grandmother. Mm-hmm. We see the woman in the gowns, the woman in the pearls. What she said was to hide her neck, which she didn't like the way it looked. Someone at one point said, "You're not a very attractive first lady," or something along those lines. She said, "I'm a very attractive woman. I just don't dress very well." She had a self-deprecating humor to her. But that image we have, that portrait, that page in the history book, in these scrapbooks, I saw during their time in China, Mrs. Bush enjoyed martial arts exercise, like a Tai Chi type of thing. And there's a picture of her in a martial arts pose in sneakers, pants, and a sweatshirt. And this is just not the Barbara Bush that any of us picture. Yeah. But I always see that woman with a smile on her face and just enjoying every aspect of her life, private and public. And we're here to celebrate and continue that legacy today.
That's amazing. Would you say, is there anything that you would want people to know, like moving forward, about her legacy or how we should remember her?
So much of politics and so much of what we see and read and catch online is just, you think people are just saying it to say it. Barbara Bush was the real deal. She was genuine. She walked the walk. She talked the talk. She meant what she said. She said what she meant. She could be firm. They called her the enforcer in the family, a nickname given to her by her son, George W. But when she was needed by her country and by her family, she stood up in a genuine, humble, and effective way. And it's a legacy that will outlast her and us. It's just a remarkable lifetime of work.
Definitely. Well, thank you so much, Andrew, for joining us.
Always.
I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for tuning in.